Welcome to Sweet 16 coverage of the NCAA tournament on CBS Sports. Today's game is between the Kent State Golden Flashes and the Houston Cougars. And our starting lineup.
The matchup at the guard position is really intriguing. Two skilled players who used to get the job done for their respective teams.
When we get going here today, these will be the keys that each team will be paying special attention to all day long. We've officially begun the first half of play. From the corner, but he misses his target. The Golden Flashes, and they're in their motion offense, working with four around one.
Well, if you have a big guy that can find people, it really puts a lot of pressure on the D.
Thanks for joining CBS Sports coverage of NCAA Basketball. I'm Gus Johnson alongside Bill Raftery. Off the glass. He can put up points and he can move the ball.
This kid really does a good job of reading the D and seeing the whole floor. And he loves to give it up. He really does a good job of scoring as well. Inside.
Tump it inside. The Cougars are now getting set up. Four around one.
If you don't help out, they just kill you.
Low block. Shots up. Get fit. Jacobs handles the feed. Jump shot. And he can't get them out.
And he looks down, but...
On the left side.
Square up on the catch. That is puppies in order.
We're at the 3-minute mark. Jacobs receives the pass. Jump shot.
He got it.
Cooper's now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to the man-to-man. They find the open guy.
E-check time from long range. Can't connect from the three-point line. Dump it inside. He shoots from the corner. The senior.
Oh, I love seeing that, Gus. The players step up and hit that mid-range jumper.
They work it around the perimeter.
Expect to see these type of games in the tournament. It's a shame that one of these clubs will be out. The final buzzer sounds. With him in their lineup, they've got someone who's been there before and he has the experience to get through some tough situations. That experience on your roster will help many coaches sleep at night.
The Cougars set up into their four around one offense.
If you have a good postman, very tough to defend. Everything centers on him.
Second team foul. To the line.
motion or around one. Understanding what type of shot you want is essential in this offense. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. Out on the left wing. From the corner, and nails it from three. Game clock. Jacobs handles the pass. Fires. Shots off. Rebound and run. In the post. In the lane. Off the mark.
Makes them so competitive on the glass.
Changing it up against the zone. That's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings. On the wing. He unloads the three.
Survive in advance. I'm certain that these teams will come out and do whatever it takes to survive. Nobody wants to be making that long loser's walk to the locker room tonight.
Well, Bill, this young man's now in his second season of eligibility.
He's still young, but the coach has him out there for a reason. He tends to make the right decisions out there, which means playing time for him. A simple concept that applies to everyone, regardless of age or experience.
He gets it to go. Looking to get in a bit of a rhythm here. Cross court. Turnover. He'll want that one back. Jump it inside. Turnover committed by the senior. Ooh, set up four around one.
That's tough because guys can make shots and they can penetrate and kick.
Jacobs.
receives the ball.
In the lane.
Shots off.
See the floor. He did some easy fast breaks.
Taking it to the cup, Bill.
Those aggressive drives are what propels this offense. There's no reason why they shouldn't continue to do this.
Thomas in the post. And he lays it up and in. 3 minutes left on the game clock. The Cougars now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
And what they do is put it on the deck, creating the pitch, and then find the open guy.
Jump shot.
Perfect.
Got a turnover. Now it comes the other way. Cooper's in there for a round one motion.
Dribble drive, the ability to understand when to put it on the deck and when to screen.
Out on the right wing. Fires. And this guy is a complete player in the post.
He's one of those type of post players that get it done in a variety of ways. In the paint, from 12 to 15, he can knock it down, passes it a little. A skilled player with a great head for the game.
Cut back door and receive the pass.
Boy, well-timed backdoor cuts. They're just pretty to watch, Gus. Not to mention the finish.
Coach, you gotta love tournament games like this. Great first half. Second half is much the same. I don't know. What do you think?
God, this is a close one, Gus. I think the last few possessions are going to dictate who moves on and who goes home.
Less than a minute and a half to go. Kent State trying to take the lead. 1 point game fading away. Doesn't connect. Houston hanging on so far. A minute to go. Pulling up. Knocks it down. 3 point game. 1 minute to go. Trip to the Elite Eight on the line. Kent State was up here in the second half. Houston, though, fighting back, taking the lead. 45 seconds, good pass down low, heading to the line. For some free throws here, that foul on Jamal Sheed. Clutch free throws. Knocks down the first one, 25-27. Malik Jacobs, 3-for-3 at the line. Let's see if he can make it 4-for-4 to pull to within one. And he does. 27-26. Houston only up by one. 40 seconds to play here in the Sweet 16 matchup. Able to escape. Let's see what Houston does here. Do they go for a two and take a three-point lead? Oh, he was wide open for three. I don't know why he didn't take it. Marcus Sasser, I believe. Or no, that was Sheed with it. Decides to pull it back out. Going to use some clock. Reset the offense here. High pick and roll. Oh, I thought he was able to break free, but they bring the double. 10 seconds. Takes it at the elbow. Misses. Kent State with a chance to take the lead. They take a timeout to talk this one over. All right, coming out of the timeout. Let's see what the Golden Flash is set up. They could save it for the last shot here and try to go for the win. We got 12 seconds. 9, 8, 7. Looking down low. Good pass. Heading to the line. Foul by Jerace Walker. Uh-oh, the big guy, though, at the line, Clyron Hornbeek. First shots at the line this game with 6.9 seconds to go. Knocks down the first one to at least tie it up. Clutch free throw right here. This would be a monumental upset, 13 seed Kent State. And he knocks down the second one. Houston takes a timeout, Kent State in the lead.
All right,
coming out of the timeout here. Let's see what Houston drew up. 4-3, you got to go faster. You're going to take a terrible shot for the win. Oh, we got it to go! Onions! Onions! Houston! Woo! I said that's a bad shot. Call me Paul George. Houston is Damian Lillard. Oh my gosh, that was insane! What a buzzer beater! What a buzzer beater! That was crazy. Congratulations to Houston. Moving on to the Elite Eight. Heartbreak for Kent State. Heartbreak. But thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. I had fun recording that one. And I will see you all later. Onions!